If you could see the world through my eyes, vibrant purple sunrise, shards of broken dreams come raining down.
Mark here, Life and Fitness Files. Thank you for watching. Make sure to like and subscribe so you can stay up to date with content and videos. Today I'm going to be diving into VO2 Max, anaerobic performance, one of Dr. Peter Attia's four pillars of exercise and fitness. So what is it? What are the benefits? And how can I get started? What does this look like in practice with some examples? So first, what is VO2 Max? Essentially, VO2 max is the volume or rate of blood that your body is able to use over a period of time. So VO2, volume of oxygen. You can go get this professionally tested. However, it is not essential that you go get this tested to be able to improve or do VO2 max work, but it can give you a baseline so you can see improvements over time. If you have a Garmin watch, it does give you a VO2 estimate on your watch using calculations from your age, weight, and different speed of your workouts. I have no idea how accurate it is, but it could give you a baseline. Doing high intensity work helps build your VO2 max. This is essentially work done at 90% or more of your max heart rate. I'm gonna give you some examples here shortly. If you check out my video on Dr. Peter Attia's four pillars, I go into the importance of building an aerobic base through zone two work, as well as building your peak of the triangle, as he talks about, through anaerobic zone five work. So you want to have both. Why is this important? What are the benefits? So the data is incredibly strong, showing that VO2 max is highly correlated with longevity and health. If you go from low to below average, there is a 50% reduction in mortality over a decade. To me, that is astronomically huge. So going from low to below average is a 50% reduction in mortality over a decade. As I've talked about in many videos, going from nothing to something is huge. If you go from low to above average, it's about a 60% or 70% reduction in mortality. So the higher you go, the better it is. However, going from nothing to something is the biggest increase. Other benefits. VO2 max improves your glycolytic capacity. So glycolysis, what is that? It is the metabolic pathway through which glucose generates energy in our cells. Probably something that's super important. Glycolytic capacity, glycolysis, this is something that decreases and we lose with age. So the more we can work on VO2 max at sustaining this, we're going to be better off, because generating cellular energy is something we're going to need for all of our life. Another important benefit, as seen in Dr. Rhonda Patrick's podcast, she talks about vigorous exercise causing muscle lactate. When you create that lactate, it is something that crosses the blood-brain barrier and is a messenger for the brain to produce neurotrophic factors like BDNF. She calls BDNF the youth elixir for the brain. So this is something that is created because of lactate that goes to our brain, creates BDNF, and is important for brain function. She talks about how this can be done at 70 to 80% of max heart rate to get into what's called vigorous activity. But high intensity VO2 max work is going to produce a lot of lactate and in turn create BDNF, which is incredibly important and feeds our brain. So yet another huge benefit to doing hard work like VO2 max work. So how do I get started and what does this look like? There's many methods to incorporate, but one important factor to note. People ask, can I do zone two work in conjunction with zone five workout? You can. You want to do the zone two workout first, followed by the zone five workout. The zone two workout allows you to get the benefit of the aerobic work, increasing your mitochondrial function, followed by the zone five workout and increased lactate and VO2 max. If you reverse them and you do the zone five work first, it sets off a lot of physiological and hormonal changes that will inhibit benefits of the zone two workout. You want to do the zone two first and get the benefits of both by doing the zone five after the zone two work. So an important note. There's a lot of methods you can choose to incorporate high intensity work. You can do 1 minute high intensity work with 90 to 95% of heart rate max, 1 minute on, 1 minute rest. You can do things like what they call Tabatas, which is on-off protocols. You can do this with jumping jacks, burpees, you could do it on a bike, you could do it with running, you could do squats. So 1 minute on, 1 minute off, do this for 5 or 10 minutes and you have a high intensity workout. You can also do a 4x4 protocol, as I've heard on Dr. Peter Attia, Huberman Lab podcast, along with Dr. Martin Gabala on Dr. Rhonda Patrick's podcast. 4 minutes on, 4 minutes off. I use the 4x4 protocol with running. This can be done with a zone two workout first, followed by the high intensity work. You can just start with a warm up, 5 to 10 minutes, and go into that high intensity work, but make sure that zone two workout is first before you go into the high intensity work. I do 4 minutes at a fast speed, but not too fast. You have to be able to sustain this for 4 minutes if you're using this protocol. A good guideline to start with is slightly faster than a 5K race pace. It will feel hard, as it's supposed to. The first couple of minutes, you might want to go faster, but make sure you are working to sustain a speed. Your heart rate will start creeping up. By the third minute, you're gonna feel pretty tired, and that last minute, you're gonna feel really tired. If you don't feel pretty tired at the very end, you can try going slightly faster on subsequent rounds, and it might take a little work to dial in what is your speed to get to the heart rate, max heart rate that you want to get to. You always want it to be hard, as that is the intent. If it isn't hard by the end, then go harder. One of the other things to mention is that I heard on Dr. Peter Attia's podcast, Dr. Enigo San Milan. He does something specific where he does 4 to 5 zone two workouts per week, and he tags on a 5 minute high intensity session at the end of every zone two workout. So he's putting all of those zone five intervals spread out throughout the week. This is something you can do and see if that works for you. I use the 4x4 protocol. I do that one time per week. Personally, I find the 4x4 protocol one time per week ideal. I cannot do VO2 max work later in the afternoon. I can do weights and some zone two later in the afternoon and still get to sleep. If I do high intensity work later in the afternoon or evening, definitely not good. So choosing a day, one day a week, where I do high intensity work in the morning, my body can be back to homeostasis. I can get to sleep. But if you want to spread this out after every zone two workout, you could do that, as your body will not be as high intensity if you're only doing it for a few minutes at the end of every zone two workout. So you can try some of these different protocols, see what works for you. At first, you might wanna just try a couple minutes and that's it. Then you can increase that over time. You'll wanna play around with the speed if you're doing that 4x4 protocol, or maybe you wanna do it with biking or something else. I've covered VO2 max anaerobic performance, one of Dr. Peter Attia's four pillars of exercise. Like I mentioned, you wanna build a foundation before diving into this, but this is a critical part of overall fitness. And if you are not putting this into your workout routine, you're missing a huge benefit in your health and longevity. As I've said in many videos, you do not need to be perfect. Start slow. You don't want to get injured. But if you can slowly incorporate this into your routines and build on it and build consistency, you're going to see a lot of benefits. I'm going to be creating more videos of routines and protocols specific to VO2 max high intensity work from Dr. Peter Attia's pillars, as well as other routines that cover strength, zone two, as well as balance and stability. I will be linking those in the description below. Be sure to subscribe and like this video to stay up to date on new videos. Comment, send questions asking me about what you want to know, as well as what you want to see. Thank you for listening, and here's to life and fitness.
Yeah.
Peace out.
Afraid of what you might lose. Walking miles and someone else is you.